Did you know that Instagram is a search engine? Yep, people Google it on Instagram. And how we find the content that connects and converts is critical when you're working your buns off to get findable in Instagram. I'm gonna show you some easy, quick ways to be the most findable business on Instagram. You don't have to be a teenager to be on Instagram. And Instagram is one of the fastest social media networks for business. My teenage son used to say to me, "Mom, by the time you're on that social media, we're long gone." And everyone else is left. The old people are left on Instagram. I'm putting myself in that same category. But what I have to understand is, like, these social media sites become really hot for teenagers. And then, of course, then they bump off and they go to something else like Snapchat. But there's still an amazing, interesting amount of data that is happening with Instagram now. Let me show you what that is. 1 billion new users every single month to Instagram. So this is a massive market that you as a business owner really need to figure out. 95% of Instagram users are also on YouTube. So very important that we connect the dots between Instagram and YouTube. Very important, because these people love content and they also want to watch it on YouTube. 70% of teenagers are actually still on Instagram, although I think that number is probably dropping significantly. So I get a lot of people asking me about, should my company be on Instagram? How is that in the marketing mix? And I know it's a lot, because we've got our website and Facebook, and now we have LinkedIn and Twitter. There's a lot going on here, right? So let's take a look and see kind of how Instagram works and if it's a good fit for you. So I'm going to go ahead and walk over here. I'm going to show you on my computer. So this is my Instagram profile, and I've worked very, very hard over a very short period of time to build following. So I've been on Instagram probably about 6 months. I've got 7,800 followers. Now, a big part of my strategy is, of course, making sure that this is the very best it can be. So when you're looking at it, not only does it have to be business related, but it also has to convey my personality. And not everyone's gonna watch my YouTube videos. So take a look at this. So of course, I wanna always name it with my business name, or if you're a personality, obviously you wanna name it your company name. Now when you come down here, you'll see that you have this little tiny screen here. It's almost like a profile. These are called highlights. Highlights are where you can take specific stories. So a story is like instant shot of what's happening right there in the moment, only lasts for 24 hours. But you can take that story and save it to a highlight so that it lives for a lot longer than just a story. So you'll see I've got all my different elements of my business. And whenever I do an Instagram story, I'm able to then save it and put it into a highlight. So if I grab one of these and I click on the highlight, I'm gonna click on the workshop highlight. Do you see how all of these are pictures of my retreats? They've been taken from my Instagram stories. If I hadn't have saved them in highlights, they would have just gone away. And we work really hard on those stories, so I would recommend that you hold on to them and save them under a respective highlight. Okay, so let's get out of there. Now, this is called the Instagram feed right here, okay? So when we're thinking about feeds, this is just what shows up in the order that you post it. So you'll see here that my social media team's having a good time on me here. Whatever. But Canva is the ultimate design tool, and they put a beret on me. Why not? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this. Now you'll see here I've got a description right here of exactly what they're going to see when they click on this. And then you could have up to 10 different hashtags in one Instagram post. You can also put emojis in an Instagram post. You can tag other people in an Instagram post. Right now, this is what I've got here. Now, you'll see there is a play button. So we have uploaded this video to IGTV, which is Instagram's version of YouTube, but it's inside the ecosystem of Instagram. And then, of course, when I hit this, you can see that it plays a little animation. And, of course, every single one of these then is driving back to my YouTube videos. Let me show you some more images here. So I'm a geek. Like most business owners, I'm a geek. Around anything with my logo on it, I go crazy for. So I just got these new pins. And if you'd like a pin, I'm happy to send one to you. Just put pin in the comments below, and I will get a pin out to you. Plus, I will send you one of my books, because you've stayed on this long, I'm going to make sure that you get a copy of one of my books and a pin. So if you'd like a book and a pin, make sure to put pin inside the comments below. Okay, so you'll see here that I've got X amount of content. There's my next one. Now this is an IGTV, so if you click on this, it is going to go directly to the videos that I post inside of Instagram. So let's do a little bit of an Instagram tutorial here, because there's a lot of moving pieces in Instagram. And I don't know about you, but the older I get, the more I feel left out of this whole game. So I have to work pretty hard. So we have the feed, we have stories, and we have IGTV, okay? So the feed is where all those boxes are on the homepage of your Instagram profile. That's where you see all the boxes. That's considered the feed. Now what you post to your feed lasts forever, okay? So that's just what happens in your feed, it's just a post. Now, stories are where you go in and you actually record yourself saying something really short, or you have something that's happening that day. Now, the difference is this is a square, and Instagram stories are like this. So they're really tall. And you might have a bunch of stories that you knit all together so that you can say, I'm doing this, and now I'm doing this, and now I'm doing this, and now I'm doing this. And it, again, it's like a story, where I'm telling you a story of my day, remember 24 hours, and I'm creating little tiny pieces over that time period. So that's what a story is. Now, IGTV, Instagram television, is where you take a video, you upload it directly to IGTV. Once it's uploaded to IGTV, then I can share it as a story, and I can share a story to my feed. So that's sort of the ecosystem that is Instagram. If you have any additional questions about how Instagram can help your business to get more exposure, to help with search engine optimization, as well as hashtags, right? If you have any questions about these things, please go ahead and post in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because I love demystifying the crazy world of internet marketing into easy, non-technical bites, delicious bites, that you can take in and do for your business every single day. Thanks for watching. I hope you loved the content of our video today. I am crazy about Instagram, and I hope that you become crazy about it too. If you love Instagram and you want to comment on this video below, put pin, P-I-N. I'm gonna send you a Findability University beautiful enamel pin and, surprise bonus, a copy of my book, a hard copy of my book, and I'm gonna cover shipping. I just really appreciate you watching this long, and please make sure to subscribe to my channel so I can keep giving you great social media and SEO ideas. Thanks for joining our community, and I'll see you on our next video.